Under glorious blue skies, Catford Wanderers are getting ready for their first league game of the season. The first 11 have a mix of youth and experience, but today the age range of the side is huge.
From 72 to 17, I would say.
From 62 down to 17.
The older members will always be there for the club they love.
A lot of the guys are old, still at the game anyway. And I think a lot of the guys will still love to see the club continue. That's why they're here trying to keep the club going as such. I mean, if it just disappear, I think they'd be a problem for the club.
We just like to pass the baton on, you know, and to keep the club going. I mean, that's why we've sacrificed so much, really. That's why I'm out here playing today at my age.
But the younger Wanderers are all in their late teens or early 20s, and the club seem to be missing a whole generation of players.
It's just a different era.
It's different.
Different era. There's much more things that, you know, expected of the younger generation anyway. And I think also the way Britain has gone in terms of, you know, the new management style. I've always said to people, it's the new management style. And myself and Percy, we were playing, we were getting days off to play cricket.
Yes, we were.
You don't get that no more.
For the youngsters playing today, the wide age range of the team has its ups and downs.
They're still learning off them as an older generation that's played at a higher level that most of them.
It's true,
that Percy's played at a high level, so we're still learning off them as well. So
Their experience is good. Well, I do agree with Ashley when he says that, but the way some of them treat the Colts is a bit, you know, like we do a lot of the legwork, shall we say.
Yeah.
Boundary markers, stumps out, you know.
We just need more youngsters.
The Wanderers do have more young players on their books, but they're away studying until later in the summer.
There's two that go uni, like two of the opening bowlers.
I'm back from uni.
He'll be properly back from uni. And then there'll be a couple guys, because one of the first team plays football professionally. So he needs to come back as well properly and recover from injuries.
Got Jason Walker to come back.
Yeah, definitely.
He's a bowler.
When he was like 17, he took the most wickets in like for the twos.
In the league, which is
quality.
So when all are available, the blend of youth and experience should work well for Catford. But today the pressure is on the veterans to perform against Walmer Cricket Club. The home side started well and came very close to getting an early breakthrough. But the visitors' batsmen soon settled and runs began to flow. The Wanderers' spin attack reduced the opposition to 141 for four. But aggressive hitting by Andrew Burkett took him to a cracking century, and the visitors were on top. Catford missed chances in the field, much to the annoyance of the home support.
Catches win match.
And Walmer went on to declare on 282 for 6 from 47 overs. In reply, Catford lost an early wicket. And skipper Dave Marshall steadied the ship. Wickets kept falling. And when the skipper was bowled, the home side collapsed, leaving youngster Remy Che to try and bat out for the draw. But despite his best efforts, he was left stranded on 15 not out as the Wanderers were bowled out for just 108. Not the best way to start the new season.
Fielding the bowling first innings was awful from us, I suppose. And then we started so poor with the bat as well.
Yeah, not good, but at the end of the day, first game of the season, so... Well, first league game of the season, so just learn from it, really.
I think we had about 7 first-team players missing for one reason or another. So we had a lot of older players today. And, of course, it took us a while to warm up. The opposition played well, but we could have done a bit better, which is disappointing for us, really.